أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم شهر رمضان الذي أنزل فيه القرآن هدى للناس وبينات من الهدى والفرقان صدق الله صدق الله المولانا العظيم My dear brethren, Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. I have quoted a verse from the Holy Quran, from Surah Al-Baqarah, that is chapter 2, verse 185. It says, Shahru Ramadan alladhi unzila fihi al-Quran. Ramadan is the month in which the Quran was revealed. Hudal linnasi, in it is guidance for mankind, not only for the Arabs, not only for the Indonesians, not only for the Pakistanis, but for the whole of mankind. Hudal linnasi wa bayyinatin min al-huda wal furqan, and it is a fuller explanation of the revelation of God, and a guidance, and as a discrimination, as a standard of judging right from wrong. This is the Quran, the final revelation of God Almighty to mankind. So Ramadan is the month in which the Quran was revealed, and two verses before this one, in verse 183, we are told, Ya ayyuhal ladhina amanu, say, O you who believe, O men of faith, kutiba alaykum siyamu, kama kutiba ala ladhina min qablikum. Says, fasting has been ordained for you, has been prescribed for you, as it had been prescribed for those before you. La'allakum tattakun, that ye may learn self-restraint, that ye may learn discipline. The purpose of fasting, we find here, told to us by God Almighty, is not just to starve ourselves, but that we may learn self-discipline. And there is nothing new in this. It is not entirely something novel that God Almighty had ordained this system of fasting for the previous religious systems. In Judaism, the religion as taught by Moses, fasting was prescribed. In the religion as preached by Jesus Christ, Hazrat Isa alayhi salam, fasting was prescribed. And we read in the Christian scriptures, in what is called the New Testament in English, that Jesus Christ, he told his disciples that when you fast, do not fast as the hypocrites do. They do not wash their faces and they do not brush their hair. But when you fast, you must wash your face and brush your hair of a happy countenance, that nobody knows that you are fasting, because you're fasting for the love of God. So in Islam, this is one of the major principles, pillars of Islam. And we Muslims, we fast from before sunrise to sunset. Before dawn, we can have a little breakfast. And the whole day, from sunrise up to sunset, not even a sip of water, no smoking, no sniffing, and other normal relationship which might exist between, let's say, the husband and the wife, even those relationships of satisfying your sexual needs are forbidden. And it is a great discipline. And the only witness to this system of fasting is God Almighty himself. And we are told in the books of Hadith that Allah Bari Ta'ala, he himself will reward the faithful, the one who has fasted from his own presence, because the Muslim has done this for the love of God only. And nobody is a witness to this, because in the privacy of one's own home, from the cool refrigerator, he can take out water and he can drink. Who is a witness to that? Nobody, except Allah. So with the fear of Allah, the love of Allah, this makes the Muslim to obey this pillar of Islam. Wa akhir da'wana alhamdulillahi rabbil alameen.